Welcome to the Oak Ridges Corridor Conservation Reserve. This rich natural area is located in Richmond Hill and contains diverse habitats and wildlife. All year long, you can connect with nature on the kilometers of trails. But unfortunately, this area and many other green spaces in the Toronto region are surrounded by paved surfaces which get salted in the winter. Road salt is a growing concern in watersheds across the Toronto region. We use road salt on roads, sidewalks, and parking lots in the winter months to keep them safe for traveling. The most commonly used form of road salt is sodium chloride. This is because it is economical to purchase, readily available, and effective. So what is the issue? Why is road salt a concern? The main problem is that we are applying way too much salt. It is estimated that over 5 million tons are applied in Canada each year, and Toronto alone uses 130,000 tons, an amount equal to the weight of the CN Tower. And with climate change, we are using more road salt because of the increase of freeze-thaw cycles. Once salt melts ice, it does not break down or settle out of water. Instead, it dissolves easily in water and flows from roads and parking lots into stormwater systems, and then into creeks, wetlands, rivers, and lakes, where it continues to persist. Given the high rate of urban development, the amount of salt entering water sources from runoff is continuing to rise. Chloride naturally occurs in fresh waters in really low concentrations and can have significant impacts at increased concentrations. TRCA's Regional Watershed Monitoring Program tracks water quality in streams across the region in partnership with the Provincial Water Quality Monitoring Network. Data collected suggests that chloride levels are continuing to increase over time. Between 2016 and 2020, average stream chloride levels at 35 of 47 stations exceeded Canadian water quality guidelines for the protection of aquatic life. In the winter months, chloride concentrations are much higher, with some GTA rivers and streams as salty as seawater. These salty conditions are toxic to many plants and animals and can kill frogs, turtles, fish, and stream-dwelling bugs. Large animals such as deer can venture to roadsides to lick the salt, resulting in increased road accidents. And for humans, chlorides can contaminate drinking water and damage infrastructure such as roads, buildings, and cars. Road salt can also lead to salt-stained boots and harm your pet's paws. So what can you do to make a difference and decrease salt use on your own property? What you can do is prepare. Shovel your driveway and sidewalk as soon as possible and shovel the snow off again just before sundown to prevent the melted water from turning to ice. Redirect downspouts away from paved areas to prevent ice from forming. Break up ice patches with a steel chopper or a similar tool. You can also create traction on ice patches. Common materials such as sand and kitty litter can reduce the potential for slips and falls. If you have shoveled the snow, broken up the ice, and tried to create traction, and you still need to use salt, ask yourself a few questions before salting. First, what is the temperature? Road salt begins to lose effectiveness below minus 7 degrees Celsius. Spreading salt on a cold day won't get rid of the ice and will only lead to more salt damage. Second, is the forecast predicting warmer weather? If you have shoveled the snow, the sun can usually provide enough melting to avoid the use of salt. Lastly, how much salt should you use? Although you might think that the more salt, the better, only 1 tablespoon of salt for a 1 meter square area of ice, about the size of a sidewalk slab, is all you need to get the job done. If you do apply road salt on your property and have leftover salt after the ice has melted, you can sweep up this salt and use it for another time. Another action you can take to reduce road salt applications is to share information and resources with your peers. Organizations such as Smart About Salt provide information on the negative impacts of road salt and best practices on proper winter salt use. To learn more about chloride levels in the Toronto region, explore the Interactive Watershed and Ecosystems Reporting Hub. you will find the guidelines for chlorides and other water quality parameters, the monitoring data across watersheds, and how levels are changing over time. Visit trca.ca to access the Watershed and Ecosystems Reporting Hub and to find a trail in the Oak Ridges Corridor Conservation Reserve.